Thank you. smart.
Yeah, certainly, well, 14 years of service.
We did 14 years of service.
Yeah.
And the love, the love.
This is Sanskrit, prose, not poetry. If our attachment is transferred to the Lord's service, we progress. Srila Rupa Goswami prayed to the Lord that he would be as naturally attracted to the Lord's service as young men and young women are naturally attracted to each other. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibited such attachment to the Lord when he jumped into the ocean or cried at night in separation. However, if our attachment is diverted to material things instead of to the Lord, we will fall down from the spiritual platform. Api bhata savai kripana ena balako mitta harini suto ho vamanayasya satha kila tamate akita sukritasya pita visrambha atma pratyayena tat aviganayam sujana iva gamishyati. Translation, Bharat Maharaj would think, alas, the deer is now helpless. I am now very unfortunate. My mind is like a cunning hunter, for it is always filled with a cheating propensity and cruelty. The deer has put its faith in me, just as a good man who has a natural interest in good behavior forgets the misbehavior of a cunning friend and puts his faith in him. Although I have proved faithless, will this deer return and place its faith in me? Report, Varnaraj was very noble and exalted, and therefore when the deer was absent from him, he thought himself unworthy to give it protection. Due to his attachment for the animal, he thought that the animal was as noble and exalted as he himself was. According to the logic of Atmavan, Manyate Jagat, everyone thinks of others according to his own kind of position. Therefore, Maharaj Bharata felt that the deer had left him due to his negligence, and that due to the animal's noble heart, it would again return. That was 15 and 16. So, Hariom Tatsat. Let's end the translation purport of Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 8th chapter, 15th and 16th verse, by a translation purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Saint Prabhupada, Srimad Bhagavatam by Lord Vyasadeva, in the matter of the character of Bharat Maharaj. So, describing the symptom before in the previous verse, it said that Bharat Maharaj would do his pujas and rituals and meditation. Sometimes he would interrupt just to see, is the deer all right? Where was the deer? So this way, he would be thinking a lot about the deer spontaneously, giving his blessings to the deer sometimes. So what was happening was that gradually the attachment which was supposed to be transferred to Krishna was being transferred to the deer. He had so many attachments as the emperor. He was the emperor of the entire world. He had his queen, he had his children, he had his kingdom, he had so many things. He left that all for meditating on Krishna and becoming fully Krishna conscious. And then without his awareness, he's becoming attached to this deer. It shows us how Maya is so strong, how we can get detached or attached in different ways. Especially since he was renouncing everything, it was the most inappropriate. It's one thing if he was a young grihastha, just getting married, and okay, he'd be attached to his wife and family, and husband and family, whatever, depending if it was a lady. But the point is that he's already advanced in age, and he's designed himself to renounce everything. And he's living in his hermitage in the side of a river in a forest. And instead, he gets attached to the deer. So his attachment is coming very spontaneously. What's the deer doing? Where's the deer? Sometimes the deer wouldn't come, and then he's lamenting, oh, what happened to the deer? Maybe it's because of my bad behavior, you put faith in me, and I didn't properly take care. But he was getting a bit, oh, it's like really over the hill, over the top, over the what was needed. Babies are very enchanting, and even the baby animals. You see baby cats are so cute, baby foals. Somehow the deer having accepted him like a parent, because the deer's mother had died. So then this natural kind of bonding had developed, which is very beautiful, very much in the heart of goodness and some respect. Probably very enchanting for modern some certain types of modern New Age people. But from the strict spiritual point of view, it was a fallen. Laws of karma are very strict. Whatever we get attached to, that leads us to our next birth. So because he got attached to the deer, his next birth, he became a deer. That's why we should know that. So how all that happened, it's explained here. You can see it was a really deep kind of attachment was developing. It was an emotional involvement with his deer. It wasn't just a casual, okay, let's take care of the deer, it's helpless. That's how it started within the development. How it's developing, how we got so much involved with this deer. So that at the time of death, instead of thinking about Krishna, he thought about the deer. What are we going to think about at the time of death? That's what destination we get. It's like I get no Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj. He's preparing himself. He wants to prepare himself for death so he can be completely focused on Krishna and Prabhupada. So he's changed the gears and everything. So that now he's just fixed on Krishna. There was one of my godbrothers, he said he went to see his father who was on the deathbed, and all the relatives were there, everybody's crying, Daddy, Daddy, Granddaddy. And he said, don't worry, don't worry. And, you take care of the dogs, you take care of the cats, and you take care of this, and you get, you know, everything will be alright. And, so he's like completely thinking about all the things. And then they got my godbrother, he thought, and I got it. Help my father just a little bit. Try to help him. So I asked him, give me 5 minutes alone with my dad. It's once in my life, about 5 minutes alone. I talked to him, it was my last chance. So everybody got and came out. Then he told him, look at dad, you're not going to die. You're eternal. The soul just wants to chant this prayer with me. It's for a blessing for you. And you have to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And for a minute, the father was like, all the stress went away. He came back, Krishna, really, I don't die. You just leave. The bike explained about reincarnation, just leaving. And you can just think about God at the time of death. But meanwhile, outside, what you doing? Maybe they're signing a will, or you know, taking all the inheritance, or who knows? You know, all of a sudden, just pow, 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 and pow. Hey, man, hurry up! Time about 5 minutes, or you know. So then they open the door. Hey, man! The whole thing all over again. Everybody's completely. He gets all stressed out. At least for one time, you can chant Hare Krishna. And it's so difficult. At that moment, when leaving the body, everybody should be helping you remember Krishna. So the guy's remembering his cats and dogs, so that's very dangerous. People don't understand it. The laws.
He was ready to accept.
Spiritual wisdom.
actually in it. It was so, so good about that. So. But sometimes I go into like the doldrums. And you're sailing across this part of the ocean where there's no wind. Doldrums. You're just, no wind. You're just there in the middle of the ocean and the waves. But there's no wind to move the fill of the sail, so they're going to start. And there's some part of the ocean that's specifically called the doldrums. You have to, if you happen to get into that area of the ocean, then it's very little wind, it takes a long time to get out. Sometimes boys, they feel like they're in the doldrums, they're not going anywhere, or they're kids. And that's very dangerous. Because then my uncle's gonna keep offering us things to get attached to. He didn't bar, he had more attention. It wasn't, he wasn't really the doldrums or anything. He was actually in a ecstatic love of Krishna. He was meditating with Krishna and he'd be crying, tears would form in his eyes, he'd be ecstatic. So that someone got attached to his deer and he got distracted from his original. Instead of crying to Krishna, I was crying for the deer. Where's my deer? I want to speak to somebody, you need to get distracted. So it shows how careful we have to be in our Krishna consciousness. Not that I've been devoted for so many years, I can do anything, no problem. We have to be very, very careful. All the time. And especially if we say that we're not getting that enthusiasm, we're not getting the taste, then it means that we're in some kind of spiritual trouble. Maybe we're committing Vaishnava Paras, Kritu Krika, or others. And therefore we lost the taste for chanting and serving. If you don't chant regularly, lose the taste, the service. Some people like to do service and they don't chant much. That goes for a while, but then without chanting, they can lose that taste. So like if we do really nice chanting, when we do our service, we should have our taste. If we're chanting committing offenses, then even the chanting might be less than full of. Whenever you chant Manchitadra Mantra, Mantra Shantana, Manchitanya, you don't consider offenses and you know the obstacle or offenses. Somehow we need to stay in a heightened state. Burwash was giving his presentation to the leaders and the glories, and he was giving a point about including that chorus and enthusiasm, but that's the fuel that they should learn. Rupa Goswami also said that the first favorable thing to our emotional service is how is enthusiasm. Sometimes they lose their enthusiasm. If we don't have enthusiasm for devotional service, then in ancient we can develop enthusiasm for other things. This puts us that much more vulnerable. To the basics, on one side, we need to do something which is a challenge for us. One time, I was asked why I knew. This would be a challenge for my senior devotees. Something for them to do. Because that's actually such a huge project. There's so many things to do. There's something for anybody. University, entrepreneurship, Jatna, Lieutenant Chief Andrew Jatna, Computer Jatna, Lord Hanson Tate. He's also active. Would they raise
him? Oh. Thank you.
We tend to work better when we're under a little bit of pressure. So being in a group of recording, we tend to do it, we're going to try a little harder than if we just do it on our own. And if you know where you have some of the people, maybe you ask them and they're supposed to be responsible for them. If you don't have to record anymore, the tendency will be supposed to be. For the brahmacharis in the ashram, they also have a counselor group that is a brahmachari counselor. And they meet every day. And they chant, they read the shastra, study the shastra for an hour and a half a day. The system is that the total temple is maintained by the congregation. All the finances, management, shopping, everything. Deity worship. Only the deity worship, cleanliness, and a certain amount of preaching is done by the brahmacharis and the ashrams. So the brahmacharis, they have to be sadhus, so they have to do more studying, be learning, learning in the scriptures. It's like a monastic life for them. Very interesting. Are we unique in this kind of the concept? I don't think they even have that concept to move it up. So I'll just show that. But again, they're members of the group. See, because one of the big problems here with Varanaraj, he had no peer. You know, there's no guidance. He didn't consult his guru. Is it all right that I'm so attached to this earth? There's nobody else telling me, hey, what's the thing going on with the deer here? He's all alone. So it's dangerous for us. And we're very secluded. So being in a group, it's very easy to live in a city in the modern world and be very secluded. Nobody knows what you're doing. Nobody cares what you're doing. You're just sitting in all of the world. Some people are committing suicide here in the West, in the middle of the city because they feel lonely. Right? It's a common thing, they feel lonely. They're with millions of people here. Nobody cares about anything. I was walking around to them once again. Seeker on the street in San Francisco, and then within about 40, 50 feet of me, some guy pulls out a gun and shoves it in somebody else's stomach and shoots it. I like 50 feet away because some people have been kind of just walk by the guy's lying in the yard. Nobody goes to help him. He was looking, maybe he didn't help him, maybe he didn't. I don't even know what they were doing. I was a distance. I was like, I said, some people walk by me. I just want to turn around and walk away or something. I also didn't know. I didn't know what to do. There was all these people holding out and holding anything. At least in India, if somebody gets shot, people going help them. Even in Iraq, when people would bomb, we go to see what happened. We have another bomb to hold them. The secondary. But here in the West, people have been going to. I felt guilty for it. I didn't have to do it. I didn't want to. What do you do? I saw these other people just kind of walking around trying to play. I was just like a teenager. I didn't. Now I'm just like visiting. Formers you can see here, but I've for years been trying to get groups together here. Now I've been told that they have four groups in Boston, and they're going to have 8 by the December, that's their plan. And now they got 8 groups in Houston, they got 6 groups in San Jose, they got Roma, Roma is really taking off in North America, everywhere. action here. I was a failure to marry out of my groups. At least you can have a concert group for all these interactive activations and less than a concert group. Their concert groups don't give people a chance to sit down with their activations and part of the moment. I don't know whether they're on stage or whatever it's here. Check it out firsthand. Work for them. And all on board, there's people chanting 16 hours in counselor groups, or the Chinese and the two people in the kind of activation groups, and all the other people are just like 1 hour in the counselor. We got 88 groups though, everybody's in a group. One temple, 88 groups. I think every Sunday in the face to just announce to people we have this program and join a sub-time group. Just like Subhadra, 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 Subhadra. Satyabhama Subhadra. Satyabhama Subhadra. She's in the far region here. So people go to her house on Subhadra once a month. At least you have a once a month. So over the city you have another Australia, they have a map. And now you can do it on anything on a map with a Google flashing. It's a normal laptop map. Print it out with little symbols all over the greater metropolitan area where they had sub-summits meeting regularly. Everybody could see that I was near my house and they could come out and say where they're going and they could do it at home. They didn't like to publish the names, the addresses, and the wrong people they were asked. They were interested in going out and coming out. So, there's like 30 some groups, 30 some. Satsangs in the city. They have two programs. They have a program on Saturday only for the Indians. And their Sunday feast program is more geared for the Western Indian, it's more geared for the Western. So on Saturday it's 90% Westerners, Indians. 10%, maybe 5% of students. And on Sunday, it's maybe 64%. That seems like a good number. I want to do something for the Western. Maybe if you could do the other way, you could have a Saturday program only for Western. Everybody wears pants and shirts, and they just have an office where everybody goes and different programs, and then they'll wear Western dress or something. You want to make it really easy. I heard this in Atlanta in Rockford, UK, suburb of London. They tell me they have two meetings a week, and one meeting is in devotional clothes, and one meeting is in Western clothes. So then that way, in the Western clothes, they went out with really wrong people, and then when they went out with really, for them, I guess it's more like when you get in the inner group, you move up. He was discussing at the meeting just add Krishna, the problem is just add Krishna. When you do something, some practical things. Here we have, of course, in North America today, the new community is the richest ethnic group in America. And the Indians are national allies. The Indians here tend to be more highly educated. In India, we reach the villagers. There's a lot of villagers in the Indian West. Here they're all professional engineers, software engineers, businessmen, doctors, architects. They brought a major from the army. We had somebody from Canada. They had different people they brought, you know, the Western friends to this now hospital. So they have to have, or they have to be in some way before you do this. So we can encourage that they had groups. We had people preaching and having now happen to encourage them to invite their Western friends. Reach out that way so that we can increase our coverage to the Western people. Different things that you see practically working. Such as on Sunday from her program, she invited on the Western people. Now we're ready to actually go and with other deities. We sit and read the deities on the group. You see the people that go to Walmart. This is mainstream America, right? Walmart. You know, most of the people are very simple kind of labor people. It's not like we used to go to Macy's or something, or different people. We get there's all kinds of stratums of people in America. It's not very wealthy. Who do you want to reach out to? But actually, in America, we have people that are interested in things that are very close to what we do. We have something to contribute to a discussion. In Malaysia, I told them the warriors to join the vegetarian association of the country. And so now we have about five, the one point on now. So we tend to do things and then stop doing them. So they joined the national vegetarian council, and over a period of time they were very active. They got 5 of the 12 seats on the national council. And when the chairman was a Chinese gentleman, and he was kind of like a, almost like a guru, or some kind of spiritual leader, and he had 60,000 followers, and they're all vegetarian. And he said, if you want to do programs again, being really friendly and nice and being the young. and here people here are very nice and welcome to all your visitors and things. I wish you would wait on the bottom. So these other groups are mainly people I can say the best for us, so they can have any answers to questions. This is they're trained up like a airline or some other profession, or smile at the people when they come, answer the phone, people call, just do all the material stuff really nice. Good people, you know, the see, you know. Well, this is part of our culture, a teaching that I am. We're supposed to, anyway, treat our guests as if they were incarnations of God. Because there's some history of the Quran that sometime Krishna came to somebody else's house in disguise as just an ordinary book, and just to see how they were treated. And then later when he was treated this person very nice hospitality, then he transformed his form, showing the actual mind that came to test his ability. So you never know who's coming in the door, saying it's his form of blame. And that's the part of TT Narayana, something like that is referring to. And now that's what the Indian government, they're promoting, and for their tourism, the TT Narayana, that okay, this is our culture, because India is famous for not treating their tourist nights. People rip them off, steal their bags, you know. It's like really, so people don't go to India because you go to China, they treat you real nice, you go to the big pack, you know. So now they're trying to train everybody, they've been doing this in Malaysia now. They got huge, the government puts billboards all over the country. Tourism, treat their guests nice, show them the variety of Malaysian culture. They have the Malaysia Tourism Awards in the local language, so it's not for the tourists. Sometimes in other languages, but try to get the local people psyched up to treat the tourists nice because they're bringing the money. So now India's on a big campaign. It was even on the BBC and everything. It was on some newspapers. The new minister of tourism, some lady, I forget her name. She was able to bring up the tourism from 2 million to 3.5 million. It was almost like doubling it in 1 year. And they invited all the big tourist agents, and then when they come and have their Pacific Circle meeting in Delhi. They said, okay, the main thing, we were all you know, Sheraton Hotel, and we like your thing, but we like it all what you're showing us. The main problem is your infrastructure thing. This and that thing. We need to see things from as somebody come in and do it like as if you were a guest. And then what's your impression? I mean, how you come in, okay, see these, for us, these are worship meetings. The normal people come in, that they're just a little person, they don't know, someone has to guide them through it. Explain that this is what they do now in the Vrindavan, when they take people to the temple. It's like part of their Palace of World tours, they take the temple tour. They take them to Jagannath, Bharatanath, Shandra, and Ashimadev, and they're very friendly, Pallava Ashimadev, Prabhupada. So Kalani was saying how people see Prabhupada as Vyasa, and they have a little bit, you know, because Americans are not just worshiping human beings so much. Okay, the beauty part, some of the people that is. But when they got to see Prabhupada, they were like a little bit put off. And so what they did is they put now two displays of Prabhupada's books. They're very often in Prabhupada, but it's wrong when people put it in Prabhupada. So they put two displays of Prabhupada's books so they could relate that Prabhupada is giving all this knowledge. And as the people seem to think it much better, okay, it's the source of all these books. I like to think that I'm going to show that active thinking. What is the experience of the people when I visit the temple? So the idea is the temple should be as a holy place, especially for all the congregation, for all the... This is a tirtha, it's a holy place. So people come. Bhakti, they should know that here's the experience. I think around the tirthas all over India, but the most wonderful experiences I had is where the priests exist are very like lead you to the pujas. And when you go on like this year we went to north and the Ganges puja, but all the priests, there's like special priests there that we were doing on the puja. Could be a very cool revelation at the end of the day, but you know, okay, so one place didn't ask for any permission. They just said that Varanasi wanted you to do a Ramana Puja yard, so you would guys please come. And they had to sit down by the side of the Ganges, you know, with Bhakti Siddhartha Maharaj. And so then I said, take water in your hand and do the Sankalpa Om, Brahmai, Yavarahi, Ayurasoka Mandam Tari. And they went through the whole Sankalpa mantra, from Brahma down to the present Titi, the present name, Orta, and all, like, you know, rising sign and the constellation, everything. Today, we're going to do Bhagavad Puja. Om Tat Sat, you know, Bhagavad Vishnu, Paranam Pada. Okay, now fill it out, okay? So now, okay, so that's how we I didn't say we had to do all that, but I'm just saying this was like what, this was like a five-star puja. But then they put in the hand, like they put tulsi, not tulsi, they put lubra grass, so all kinds of flowers. I was offered so many things to the Ganges. There was like Esa, Puspa, Om Kanayanaha, Esa, Lubra Gasa, Om Nanayanaha, Esa, Dora, Mangayanaha, Mangayanaha, then, okay, the Esa Diva, Mangayanaha, you know, it was like, we did so many things, it was like 12 items, and I was like, wow, this is, you know, never been that much puja in my life in the Ganges. It was something really fun. Then he stood saying, stand up, and water came up, offer water, then water, bring the water to the Ganges, like, no, we did that before. But anyway, so they didn't miss an act. That is to stand up on a circuit and play the Ganges.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.